Everyone, I wanted to do a video about Leonardo AI, and I know I haven't done a video about Leonardo for a while, and I know I'm about 3 months late for this because people have been doing videos for this flow state 3 months ago, but I wanted to share with you this because it's so different than some of the other ways that we do prompts and kind of get what we need to get out of the AI. So they're kind of doing away with prompts. I'll show you what I mean and how it works. It's called flow state, and basically you go through and it makes different designs for you, and you kind of follow a path. So you pick one that you like and you make more like this, and then it does some more like that, and then you pick another one and another one, and you kind of go down this path until you come up with the right design idea. So I'll show you how it works. It doesn't work like normal AI where you have to keep typing on things that you want it to do. It just kind of knows because you're picking the right one. So it's all gonna make sense. Let's get into Leonardo right now and I'll show you flow state. All right, so here I am on Leonardo. You can see it's talking about experience flow state right here. Only one token per image starting March 2025, and we are in March. So we're gonna try flow state here. You can click this button or you can click image creation and we'll get started. So keep an eye out on my tokens. So I played around with this and the tokens went pretty fast. So we're gonna keep an eye out here. I'm starting at 455. Now it says only one token per image, but you're gonna see how fast those images come up. So I'm gonna try flow state here. Again, it's gonna show you 455 up here so you know how many tokens that you're using. And it's given examples of what it can do. So it's really good. Leonardo is really good at posters. So not so much for t-shirt designs, but if you're doing posters or poster-like images for t-shirts, then I think it would do really well. That's what I would use Leonardo for. So I'm gonna do some poster prompts, and you do have to start with a prompt, or you could use these prompts right here, but I'm gonna type one in. I have one that I'm thinking about using. All right, so I kind of did a different take on the, you know, the selfie cat with the UFOs in the back. So I have a black and white photo of a cat with a comical surprise look on his face, mouth open, taking a selfie outdoors, but with the Easter bunny behind him. I don't know if that's gonna work. So we're gonna go here on the left first, and we can pick a few of these things. So you can see the mode is already flow state. And then we can do automatic, or we can pick some of these vibes here. So what I want is kind of a more photorealistic one. So let's see, I'm gonna go with pro photo or street photo, actually. I think that would be good. And then for lighting, I kind of want it black and white. So let's see, I think, oh, lens flare could be really cool. Oh no, stormy. Let's try stormy since it could do that. And this is gonna be the black and white one, I believe. Shot type, let's see. I think epic, let's try epic. And color, yeah, color definitely black and white. Okay, so you can pick any of those things. I'm gonna do 2x3 instead of 1x1 and turn all of these on. Okay, so here we go in flow state. I'm gonna just hit that and hit generate. And remember, 455 right here, watch it. It already went to 432. Look at that, look at that, it's using it. It already made a few designs, so we're gonna pick one with outdoors. I'm gonna pick this one right here, but let's look what it did. It did more than 8, yeah. Okay, I think this was a good one. Oh, 414, oh, already. All right, I'm gonna say more like this and watch this now, 414. It's now 390, holy cow. Let's see, is there one that I like here? That one's funny. Let's see. So you can see it goes fast. I like this one, more like this one. So we're already down 2-3 paths here. Nice. And I think it's getting it closer and closer. You can see some of these look really similar now. After you've gone 3 steps ahead, they all kind of look similar, just some little details like the ear here, or the mouth or the clouds behind it are kind of different. So let's say you want one, or let's say, wait a minute, I didn't want it to all look like this. I can go back and go back to number two here and still look at some of the other ones. It doesn't cost you anything because we went back to the ones that we already had. Unless we start scrolling down to things we didn't see yet, maybe we want a black cat instead. Now we can go there. So if you pick this one, you're gonna go in this path now and you won't see number three. Does that make sense? Because now that you're not gonna go down this path, you're gonna go down this another path with the black cat. So watch this. I'm gonna hit more like this. And now my third version is gonna contain more of the black cat. There we go. And then we used a lot more there. So there you go, that's how it works. I'm gonna do, let's say we found one that we liked. I like this one here. And then we can just click on this. We can upscale it. We can save it to our library. We can copy it to the clipboard and so on. So I'm gonna hit save to library because I really like this one. That's a cool one. That could be a t-shirt. That could be a fun t-shirt. All right, let's try another one, not a black and white photo. I'm gonna go back, 303, man, that went so fast. I'm gonna go back to the beginning, start again here, and you can see some other stuff. So if you like these that are up here, then you wouldn't even need any prompts, but I'm gonna put in another prompt here. All right, so here is the prompt that I'm gonna use. I'm gonna use a very simple prompt to show you something else. So starry night with a silhouette of the Easter Bunny. And then let's see what it does. Oh, wait, we gotta change something. So concept art or sci-fi, I guess sci-fi. Lighting, we want it light art. So we can change all of these again, spiritual and maybe vibrant since Starry Night is like that. Okay, and here we go. We're at 303, so let's see what happens now. And again, it's gonna make at least eight here. And some really cool stuff here. Now, I could generate again and do Starry Night by Van Gogh. And let's see, I could hit generate again if I don't like any of these. So let's see. All right, so that's better with the Starry Night. Let's see. I kind of like this one. So I'm gonna hit more like this. And you'll notice, I don't know if you noticed the last time, but when I picked it, it changed the prompt. See, now the prompt is a lot longer. It's adding to it so it knows what to do. And I could add to this as well, I believe, if I wanna do this. And maybe there's something in this prompt that I don't like. I'm gonna do black silhouetted Easter, a silhouetted Easter Bunny in front of the ethereal, spiritual, energetic vibe. I don't think it needs space elements. So I'm gonna take that out and I hit generate. So this is still gonna be, I wonder if this is gonna be one or two now that we were on number two. Ah, it takes us back to one if you do it like that. All right, so let's take a look. I still like this one. So let's go down the path now. Two, three, keep an eye on the tokens here. See, look at that, 160 now. It's pretty crazy how fast that goes. So be very careful when you use this, unless you have tokens to spare, but you can see right now it's pretty fast. So I'm gonna choose this one. And I think that's great. Got some Easter bunnies there. And I'm gonna save to library. Boom. So you can also go through the two like this. If you don't wanna look at all of them together, you can just see the ones that were made here. So that's kinda neat. All right, And by the way, even though you're not using all of these, you're just looking at them, it costs you a token. So it goes super fast. So you might as well, like, if you have something that's kind of like what you like, I would save it down there. Maybe save it as a reference for later. Okay, one more, because I'm running out of tokens here. Let's try a different one. I'm going to try and put words in this next one and see how well it does. This is going to be a tarot card of an Easter bunny hiding eggs in the woods with the words, the hider. And let's see if it knows it. Let's just do a color sketch. Actually, I think tattoo might be fun. Tattoo, we got some things we can play around here. Golden hour, trying to change stuff that we didn't do. We already did spiritual. We already did epic. I don't know, dreamy sounds interesting. And then I think we did vibrant. Terracotta teal, sure. That kind of sounds interesting. And let's generate and see what comes up. I think it will do pretty well with the words, but I'm curious. It's mainly used for designs, but wow, that's pretty cool. So there's a couple of good ones. And if, so if you like two of them and you wanna branch out, you might have to just go, like, let's say I like this one and this one. I'm gonna go more like this. And then find, kind of get to the end of the row there, save that one, and then go back to the other one. So this is really nice. I like this one. He has a cute look on his face. Let's see how much different. So by the time you get to number three, they're all gonna, well, no, this one. Oh, we're still on two. I don't know what happened. Maybe because I didn't hit more like this. Maybe I ran out of tokens. I have 61 tokens. I think that's what it is. Yeah, I ran out of tokens. Dang it. 61 tokens. So there you go. I'm going to save this one. I can save any of these, actually. So I'm going to save this white one. Download. And there you go. And this one. Download. I think they came out great. They have a tarot card feel, and I know they can, it can do illustrations too. So I might as well look at all of these since I ran out of tokens pretty much. Yeah, pretty cool. All right, so that is it. That is flow state. Just be very careful. Keep an eye out on your tokens here. They go by fast. You can see I started with like 400 and now I'm, but it does posters really cool. And I didn't have to retype like in here. It does it for you. So if you want to keep this, right here, if you like the way these turned out, you can keep this, prompt here for later, for another one, but you don't have to type in add more eggs or add this or remove this because it just knows because you're picking this way and it kind of branches out from there. So I think it's a really cool idea on how to use it. Of course, just be very careful of the tokens. So there you go. That was Flow State with Leonardo. Let me know in the comments what you think of it. Do you think this is better than trying to re-prompt or do a new prompt? Is this better than doing that? It definitely is faster, I feel like. I don't know, it gives you the illusion of being faster, but then it goes through tokens super quick. Let me know in the comments which one you like, if you've used Flow State before, and if you've used or tried to get your prompt to work better with AI. Let me know that as well. If you want to see my latest video about 8 different AIs versus each other, I kind of did a video where I'm trying to find out what's the best AI for t-shirt designs. That's this video right here where I compare 8 different AIs together. Hopefully you find that informative. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.